Hey everybody, it's me, Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie. On this episode of CD Junkie, I'm going to be talking about a great band by the name of China Crisis. Now, I have talked about China Crisis in the past. I've done a CD Junkie on China Crisis, but this is a redive into their catalog because of a new reissue, plus two solo albums by Gary Daly have been released since I did the last video. Now, I always like to start these videos off by telling you how I got into the band, and that was because I heard the song Working With Fire and Steel on KROQ in LA, a radio station, and blew me away. I had seen their records in the bins previously. I'd seen a couple singles and 12 inches and at least one album at that time that I knew of. And I heard the song. I bought the American version of the album. Then I went back and bought every import I could find. And I've been a fan ever since. They've never let me down. Now, if you are not familiar with the sound of China Crisis, at the end of this video, there's about a 5.5 minute medley of songs that I compiled featuring two songs from every album that I'm talking about here. But let's dig into their catalog. Now, the best way to describe China Crisis, okay, Eddie London and Gary Daly were two friends, and they got together to write great pop songs, and they, of course, had discovered synthesizers, so they were creating these wonderful, deep songs with just whatever instruments they could afford or they can get their hands on. And the songs weren't just, you know, synth pop songs. You know, like, in fact, on their first album here, which is called Difficult Shapes and Passive Rhythms, Some People Think It's Fun to Entertain, came out in 1982. You know, they even have a song called No More Blue Horizons, which was very Steely Dan-ish. And Steely Dan makes a big appearance later in their career, and I'll tell you about that. But this is a great collection of songs. I was originally going to compare them to OMD, you know, two friends getting together, writing songs, and using synthesizers as their main instrument early in their career. But China Crisis is a whole different deal. Now, of course, they were both, you know, Liverpool area based bands, but China Crisis took a different course. They were still just as experimental and unique, and they had their own musical vision. But there are songs on here like Christian and African and White, such great songs, very diverse musically in their songwriting. There's even a song here that was a single that didn't make the album called Scream Down at Me, which is almost kind of scary compared to the rest of their material, but it's just still a great song. But China Crisis, Difficult Shapes and Passive Rhythms, came out in 1982. Definitely a great debut, but there was so much more ahead. Now, by 1983, they had added bassist Gazza Johnson and drummer Kevin Wilkinson, and they recorded and released the album Working With Fire and Steel, Possible Pop Songs, Volume 2. This is the 3-CD expanded edition. Features the album, tons of bonus material. You can definitely check that out. Now, by this time, they're tougher and rougher and beefier. Now, Gary Daly was chiefly the main vocalist, and Eddie London would sing a few songs per album. Ironically enough, Wishful Thinking, which was sung by Eddie London, that became the big hit off of this album. But this album is full of great hits. Working With Fire and Steel, Hana Hana, When the Piper Calls, Animals and Jungles. Sonically, this was a huge leap forward. Still musically diverse, but production-wise, it was bold and big and really a fantastic collection of great songs. Now, it took another 2 years for Flaunt the Imperfection to come out, and this came out in 1985. This is the 2-CD version. This is an incredible album. We're talking incredible. This is when they got together with Steely Dan's Walter Becker, who produced the album. But he not only produced the album, he was such an important part of the arrangement and in the playing that he's actually listed as a band member on the album. But this just supersedes anything that came before. I love those albums, but I was not prepared for the greatness and the depth and the emotion that this album had. Some people called it Steely Dan Light. I think that's very unfair, but if that gets you interested and you want to check it out, then okay, it's fair. But fantastic record. This has remained my favorite China Crisis album amongst favorites. And this is the 2-CD edition, loads of bonus material. Such an immensely moving, powerful, wonderful pop album that deserves to be heard. The next album, they went into the studio with Clive Langer and Alan Winstanley, who produced like Madness and Dexy's Midnight Runners 2 Raye. So many great records that those two produced. And they released the album What Price Paradise. This 3-CD expanded edition has just come out. It includes the album. It includes a bonus disc of B-sides, non-album tracks, demos, etc. And it includes a live show. I saw them on that tour. And so I'm actually going to listen to that live set. I normally don't listen to live recordings. And now I wasn't at this show, but I saw them on that tour. So it's going to bring back some memories. Now, the only negative thing on here is you'll see that it has Best Kept Secret, produced by Andy Partridge of XTC. Unfortunately, it's not that version that's included on the CD. So I just wanted to warn you beforehand. But it doesn't matter, because this whole album is just chock full of great songs. Now, even though they had used horns on Flaunt the Imperfection, they really embellished these recordings with horns. So if you've listened to Clive Langer and Alan Winston Lee's productions, they're great with horn arrangements. Like I said, with Madness, Dexy's Midnight Runners, bands like that. They added keyboard player Brian McNeil to the lineup, and boy, this is something else. It is bold in your face. It's wonderful. Bunch of great songs. Arizona Sky was a single. Best Kept Secret was a single. But there's a lot of other great songs like June Bride, We Do the Same, The Understudy. Great collection of songs. China Crisis, What Price Paradise, 1986. 3-CD expanded edition available now. 1989, they returned with Diary of a Hollow Horse. Back in the producer's chair was Walter Becker. But this was not just a retread of Flaunt the Imperfection. This album, you know, Flaunt the Imperfection, for all its wonderfulness, it sounds very tightly produced, where this sounds loosely produced, giving the instruments more space, giving the emotion and the mood to sort of float around the songs. Now, these songs were not as immediate as their previous releases, but they dug into you. This seemed to be a more personal record, and after a few listens, you will just fall in love with it. Diary of a Hollow Horse. This is the expanded 2-CD edition. The interesting thing about this is, if you notice on disc one, it's the entire album. It's the Walter Becker produced version of the album. Now, when the band had presented it to the label said, you know what? We need singles. We need to hear singles. Why don't you go back and re-record Saint Savior Square, Red Letter Day, and All My Prayers? Now, they went back in the studio with Mike Thorne, re-recorded those songs, and the label took off the Walter Becker versions of the songs, replaced them with the Mike Thorne version of the songs, and that's the album that was released. This features the original Walter Becker produced version of the album, and then as bonus tracks, you get the Mike Thorne versions, and you get a whole bunch of other bonus material. Fantastic. I actually, because I've heard the Mike Thorne versions for like 30-something years, I prefer his versions of the songs, apart from All My Prayers, which I prefer the Walter Becker version. But either way, I've got them both. Incredibly moving, deep album by a band that deserved more attention. Great songwriters. You definitely need to check it out. Now, to my knowledge, the band split up after this, and there was nothing heard from China Crisis until 1994, when Warped by Success came out. This was the band going back to basics. It was back to Eddie and Gary recording the songs. Interesting thing is, you can say to yourself that, oh, that's kind of like what they were doing with the first album, the two of them working with some friends, musicians, putting these songs together. Yes, that is true. But their songwriting had advanced so much, it was like taking the latter period China Crisis, mixing it with the early period China Crisis, and creating something new and indeed wonderful. And I'm sure that you expected me to say that. Features the song Every Day the Same. And yeah, there's a bunch of great songs. Always, Hard to Be Around. Great songs on this. Again, back to basics for the band. It was great to hear new music from them. Gary Daly has one of the finest voices, because it's so unique, and it can be fun and forceful, and also gentle and warm. Definitely an album to check out if you haven't heard it already. They followed that up in 1995 with Acoustically Yours, which is a live album. Yeah, I know that I don't talk about live albums much here, but I do talk about them if the songs are drastically redone, and that is what this is. This is a band going back out on stage and performing songs old and new in new and inspiring ways. That's the thing about China Crisis is, yes, they started as a synth pop band, but their songs going all the way back to the early days could easily be played on acoustic guitar, and they prove it on this. Great collection of songs. Now, I believe that there have been a few different versions of this. This is the original version that came out. It has been reissued as maybe China Crisis Live. And I think that maybe both of these albums were issued in like a 2-CD pack. But I didn't pay too much attention to that because I already had the originals. Now, 20 years after that, the band returned with Autumn in the Neighborhood, which is every bit as fantastic as Flaunt the Imperfection. This is a band that comes into their own with every album. Every album is majestic, and you know, it's a new experience. This is a band, yeah, they started out as a synth pop band, but you never know it by this album. This is mature, incredible songs, incredible arrangements. And although there is no Walter Becker on this album, his production spirit is felt on this. Incredible collection of songs. Yes, I know that you've never heard any of those if you are not a fan, because they weren't released as singles. But if you are remotely interested in great, wonderful songwriting, performing, playing, this is it. China Crisis, Autumn in the Neighborhood, easily my second favorite album. And I only say it's easily my second favorite album because I've only been listening to Flaunt the Imperfection for 32 years more than this. And for me to say that this is pretty much its equal, it's astounding. It just shows the talent of the band. Now, that is their final studio album. They are still together. They are still touring. And I believe they have some sort of collection coming out in 2022. But let's talk about Gary Daly. He is the lead singer. He released Gone From Here in 2019. This is an emotional album. I can see why some ways he didn't use these songs or didn't record a China Crisis album, because it's a deeply personal, emotional album. It's going to take you on an emotional roller coaster. It's filled with wonderful melodies, but they are all very intimate. You know, he does use different instruments. You know, there's synthesizers in there, there's pianos in there, there's guitars in there, but it's beautiful and it's glorious. And if you love heart-touching, heart-wrenching music, this is definitely something that you're going to want to check out. Finally, in 2020, Gary also released this album. It's called Luna Landings. And what this is, it's all instrumental, but it's all like demos and instrumentals and experiments he was doing back in the 80s. This is all songs from the 80s. No vocals. It's all synthesizers, and there are some samples on there. The interesting thing about this is you think, oh, yeah, that's going to sound boring, but it's not. This is incredible because every song has a hook. It could be upbeat, it could be slow, could be mid-tempo, and everything has a great hook to it. Now, I know just talking about a band, you know, you're going to go, ah, okay, Schnee's excited about it, but what do they sound like? Well, guess what? I've got about a 5.5 minute, maybe a little bit more than that, medley of China Crisis songs featuring two tracks from every album that I just talked about, except Luna Landings. I only have one track from that. And you're going to be able to listen to it right now, and I'll see you on the other side. Life is a fever.
Shoot. cloudy domain of the wind and the rain. The terrible times, the heartaches, the pain.
That's it. Thank you for allowing me to talk about China Crisis. I appreciate you hanging out with me for this little while. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me. I'm Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie.